Good morning and welcome to worship. It's Sunday, September 13th, 2020. Thank you for joining me and the people of Wardsville and Glencoe Presbyterian Churches as we worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My name is Reverend Deb Dolbear-Van. Our community news today is a reminder of the helpline 519-930-1012. And if you know anyone in need of food or other supplies around their home to help their family, please contact that number. Again, 519-930-1012. I'd like to extend happy birthday wishes belated to Diane Fisher and Angela Simpson and Natasha Matthews. Happy 16th birthday to Natasha. And Carson Matthews will be turning 14 on the 15th of September. Marlene Fisher has a birthday on the 16th, and Alan Woolner on the 17th. So happy birthday, everyone. And to anyone who is celebrating an anniversary, we pray that you would have a blessed week and a beautiful and wonderful day. Please join me in our call to worship. From the routines of work and school, home and play, we come to worship God. With the weight of the world, its politics and violence, heavy on our hearts, we have come to worship God. In the midst of our fears and our hopes, we trust in God's power and presence, and we offer our prayer and our praise in Jesus' name. Come, let us worship God. And now for our opening praise selection, beginning with As the Deer.
You alone are my heart's desire.
Let us pray. Let us pause now and call ourselves into mindfulness of the sacred time that is a gift, worship time and Sabbath time. O Spirit, you swept through the ages, be among us now to fill us with radical amazement at the wonder of creation and creativity. Call to us that we may hear your voice in beauty, in witness, in song, and in prayer, and respond with all that we have to offer, mind, body, soul, and spirit. Whisper to us when we doubt your goodness and despair of hope in a world fraught with signs of destruction, that we may hear yet your still small voice. And magnificent God, when we think of awe, our mind stumbles. We are too busy for awe. We know too much to be in awe. We are too jaded for awe. We ignore the spiritual gift of awe. We feel awe, yes, before a mountain, a sparkling lake, a hummingbird. We do not feel awe before the blessings of every day. Forgive us. Forgive us, Magnificent One. Help us to experience awe this week in washing dishes, in the pesky backyard squirrel, in our colleague and challenges in the evening while we're on a stroll. For we would be deeply faithful to you. All this we pray, remembering the words of our Lord's Prayer, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Hear these words of assurance and hope. Know that the ground of all being, from which all beauty, creation, and wisdom arise, is the ground of your being. Let your fears and anxious worries cease. Turn and see the beauty and the goodness from which you are formed, knowing that just to be is a gift. Rejoice today that through Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen. With deep gratitude for the healing and freedom that Jesus offers, let us present our offerings to God. Through our gifts, may healing and reconciliation be shared in God's world, in Christ's name. I encourage you to give what you are able and called to give to your local church that you love, the charity of your choice, or as the Lord leads you to give. Let us pray. Generous God, you love us with an everlasting love, and we are genuinely grateful for your love for us and your Son's sacrifice on our behalf, for the forgiveness of our sins and the resurrection of our body. Receive these gifts of money in love and use our hearts to bring peace and hope to our hurting world. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
1 million reasons why you shouldn't even try. After all, you're just one heart, a single candle in the dark. And there are shadows here feeding on your fears that you don't have what it takes. Who are you to make a change? But oh, oh, don't underestimate the God you follow. Whatever you do, just don't look back. Somebody needs a lot to have. Whatever you do, just don't lose heart. Keep on pushing back the dark. Keep on pushing back the dark. A city on a hill, it should be shining still. Every sinner saved by grace has a purpose, has a place inside the bigger plan we might not understand. But if we just keep walking on, we will see the kingdom come. Yeah. Whatever you do, just don't look back. Oh, somebody needs a light you have. Whatever you do, just don't lose heart. Keep on pushing back the dark. Keep on pushing back the dark. Let your light so shine. Let your light so shine. Oh, oh, don't underestimate the God you follow. He is the light that burns inside your soul. So keep on shining till the whole world knows. Whatever you do, just don't look back. Oh, somebody needs a light you have. Pushing back the dark, just keep on pushing back the dark, dark. Whatever you do, just don't look back. Cause somebody needs a light you have. Whatever you do, just don't lose heart. Keep on pushing back the dark, keep on pushing back the dark, yeah. When you feel like you're too small, do any good at all. Like a sunrise through the window, like a symphony crescendo. We are waking up again, we are rising from the dead. We are shining like the stars, we are pushing back the dark. Yeah, we are pushing back the dark. Yeah, pushing back, pushing back, pushing back the dark. But just pushing back, pushing back, pushing back the dark. Let your light so shine.
Dear God, school's different now. I don't understand the world, but I know that when hard things happen, I should pray. So that's what I do.
I pray that we can keep learning, whatever that looks like, and that we'll be together, even if it's in a whole new way.
God, I pray as we step into the unknown future that you continue to show me things about myself and life, things I can't learn in books. Be with me, God, no matter how this year unfolds.
Help us, God, to do our best every day.
Even when every day isn't what we thought it would be.
Keep us safe and keep us learning, one day at a time.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
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 Our scripture reading this morning comes from Matthew chapter 18, verses 21 to 35. Let us listen to the word of God. Then Peter came and said to him, "Lord, if another member of the church sins against me, how long should I forgive? As many as 7 times?" Jesus said to him, "Not 7 times, but I tell you, 77 times. For this reason, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his slaves. When he began the reckoning, one who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to him. And as he could not pay, his Lord ordered him to be sold. Together he and his wife and children and all his possessions, and payment to be made. So the slave fell on his knees before him, saying, "Have patience with me, and I will pay you everything." And out of pity for him, the Lord of the slave released him and forgave him his debt. But that same slave, as he went out, came upon one of his fellow slaves who owed him 100 denarii. And seizing him by the throat, he said, "Pay what you owe." Then his fellow slave fell down and pleaded with him, "Have patience with me, and I will pay you." But he refused. Then he went and threw him into prison until he would pay the debt. When his fellow slaves saw that what had happened, they were greatly distressed, and they went and reported to their lord all that had taken place. Then his lord summoned him and said to him, "You wicked slave, I forgave you all that debt because you pleaded with me. Should you not have had mercy on your fellow slave as I had mercy on you?" And in anger, his lord handed him over to be tortured until he would pay his entire debt. So my heavenly Father will also do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother or sister from the heart. Thanks be to God for his holy and everlasting word. Amen. The title of the message this week is, "Are You a Scorekeeper?" And Mr. Rogers said this, "Forgiveness is a strange thing. It can sometimes be easier to forgive our enemies than our friends. It can be hardest of all to forgive people we love. Like all of life's important coping skills, the ability to forgive and the capacity to let go of resentments most likely takes root very early in our lives." Barbara Brown Taylor, she wrote a sermon and it was entitled "Arthritis of the Spirit," which was resentment. And she started it by saying, "In case you have not noticed, Christianity is a religion in which the sinners have all the advantages. They can step on your feet 50 times, and you are supposed to keep smiling. They can talk bad about you every time you leave the room, and it is your job to excuse them with no thought of getting even. The burden is on you. Because you have been forgiven yourself, and God expects you to do unto others as God has done unto you." Now, this isn't a bad motivation for learning how to forgive. If God is willing to stay with me in spite of my meanness, she continues, "my weakness, my stubborn self-righteousness, then who am I to hold those things against someone else? Better I should confess my own sins than keep track of yours. Only it's hard to stay focused on my shortcomings. I would so much rather stay focused on yours, especially when they are hurtful to me." Isn't that interesting? I'm hoping that I can share the rest of this message with you, and it will be separate on YouTube because I'm having some technical difficulties downloading the song called "Forgiveness" by Matt West, and so I'd like to share that story with you as well. How he came to write that story or that song. Let us pray. God of light and hope, We pray for those who face lives filled with darkness, those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit, those bent over and those held under burdens of sorrow, those who cannot see the way ahead. We pray for those who accompany others in the dark places and times, for those who comfort the grieving and work for healing and new possibilities. May these find their darkness transformed by your presence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of liberation and justice, we pray for those who suffer abuse, violence, or injustice at the hands of powerful people or forces in their lives, and for those who have been betrayed by people entrusted with their care. Stir in all people a deep respect for life. Encourage those who struggle for freedom and work for truth to be heard and reconciliation achieved. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of peace and promise, we pray for those who work for peace in the world, for leaders and decision makers, for those who hold power and can make a difference in their communities, and for those who make, interpret, and enforce laws. Awaken a respect for the need of the most vulnerable, including the earth and its fragile balances. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And God of wisdom and understanding, we pray for those who misunderstand the words and actions of others, and for those who are misunderstood. We pray for those who teach and those who learn, especially those who struggle and are afraid to ask for help. In this challenging school year ahead, guide teachers and students in new patterns of learning and keeping each other safe and healthy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of forgiveness and reconciliation, we pray for those who have hurt or offended and for those who have been unkind. We pray for those who have hurt us and been careless with our feelings. Work in our lives to redeem broken relationships. Shape us into gracious and forgiving people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the silence we name before you others and their concerns and concerns on their minds. We pray all these things in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet
Go in peace, and may you make no records of wrong. May you forgive one another as the Lord has forgiven you, so that others may know the joy of your salvation, and they might also experience the hope of Christ in their lives. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.